everyone, and welcome to The Break Run. My name is Kevin.
And my name's Frank. And we are back on the second episode of our series about theme park and roller coaster safety. So today we're going to be breaking down when a theme park or roller coaster incident happens. What is the cause of it? Because in our last video, we talked about how safe these rides are. But unfortunately, accidents do happen once in a while. So Kevin, we broke it down into three main causes for accidents. What are they?
So first you have to look at a guest. Mm-hmm. Honestly, this is the majority of the reasons behind why accidents happen on a theme park.
Yep.
Then you have employee related, and then you have like a mechanical or just purely an act of God situation.
Yep.
So let's dive into a guest accident. Mm-hmm. What does this look like and what does it mean?
Yeah, so I think we kind of know that guests at a theme park, sometimes they don't listen to the rules. And that's ultimately because they're so excited. There's a lot of sensory overload with the lights and music and a lot of people. They're not going to listen to the rules, and that might cause a form of accident. So whether it's like you have to keep your loose objects on the side, or you're not allowed to enter ride-restricted areas, or hey, I'm not going to listen to the operator, and I'm going to stand up during the ride. That could unfortunately lead to an injury or a death.
Yep. So I think a perfect example is this would be if you were wearing a baseball cap, mm-hmm. and you experience an attraction, and while you were riding the roller coaster, your baseball cap fell off, and it fell off into a restricted area, yep. where the roller coaster track comes very close to the ground.
Yep.
Well, there's fences around these restricted areas for a reason, because the ride is coming through the area very fast, oftentimes well over 60 miles an hour.
Yep.
And if anything's in that area, there's not much hope for it.
Yeah.
So if you were to lose your hat in a restricted area, and this was your prized possession hat, these areas are cleaned at night every day, but if you don't want to wait and you jump the fence and unfortunately the ride comes by, it's not looking so good for you.
Yeah, and a lot of people have the tendency of, I can't live without my cell phone. I need it now. I can't wait 2 hours till park close. So they'll do anything to get it, which unfortunately might not be the best idea. Mm-hmm. And even to break this down further, it could be smaller, on a smaller scale. Like, please don't sit on the rails or the gates. And that's for a reason, because you could easily slip off a rail that's less than an inch thick and mm-hmm. get hurt. So I think definitely a big challenge with theme parks is guests not listening to the rules, and that could lead to something unfortunate happening.
Yep. So let's kind of talk about the next one, which is employee based. Mm-hmm. So this would be a scenario where an employee error has caused an accident on a roller coaster.
Yep.
Frank, what does that mean?
Yeah, so this could be due to numerous things. So first, it could be due to taking safety shortcuts. Like, you're trying to be really efficient, but maybe you're gonna gloss over something. It could be doing improper height checks, where you're letting someone who's maybe too small or too tall on the ride. It could be doing from being distracted by talking to friends, looking at other guests, or maybe unfortunately texting while operating a ride, or it could even be while you're running the ride in maintenance mode. So a lot of rides have two different settings: your automatic mode, which is where your operator is supposed to operate it, and then a maintenance mode for maintenance only. If you run it in maintenance mode, it could override some safety sensors that are not designed to be allowed when there's guests on the ride.
Exactly, and we talked about a lot of those sensors in our last video.
Yep.
But obviously, an example of this could be if you are running a ride with guests and the ride gets stuck, mm-hmm. and in order to try to fix the ride, a maintenance technician could come out, put it in maintenance mode to reset some block scenarios,
yep.
and unfortunately that overrides the ride safety system, and that would be purely human error at that point.
Yep, exactly.
So I think it's important as theme park operators to really focus on their safety training with employees.
Yes, because that's the stem of a lot of things as well.
Exactly. So let's talk a little bit about what the last possible cause could be, and that would be a mechanical / computer failure or an act of God scenario.
Yep.
So what does that mean?
Yeah, so that could be anything from like a ride getting struck by lightning, and like obviously the importance of why you can't run certain rides with weather conditions, or it could be to where somehow one restraint opened up midpoint during the ride, or it could even be something like a part of a ride falling off or whatnot.
Yep, and now we do need to stress these scenarios very rarely happen.
Yeah, and they rarely do happen because a lot of theme parks have a maintenance team that will do preventative maintenance, and where you're being proactive, where you every morning check certain things, where you have your daily maintenance, your monthly maintenance, and your yearly maintenance to make sure things like this don't happen.
Yeah, so think about like everybody who has a car, you have to get an oil change.
Yep.
And when you get an oil change, you check for things that are wrong with the car, you realign your tires, you do a lot of preventative
like a tune-up.
Maintenance.
Yeah.
Exactly. Roller coasters get an oil change every morning.
Yeah, basically.
Right?
Yeah.
So if any issues were happening or things that had popped up, really every day, both in the morning and at night, these are being checked.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really hard for an issue to just spontaneously pop up in the middle
yep.
of the day.
And a lot of times it's not like a quick 5-minute thing. Sometimes it's hours and hours along where you're inspecting everything from the track, the computer system, the trains, and even a lot of times it sometimes unfortunately has to go a little bit longer into when like the park is open. Or so I think that's why in our last video we talked about people think rides are so scary, and like they might be like, oh my gosh, there's a maintenance guy at the ride. It might just be doing just a quick checkup, make sure everything's good.
Mm-hmm.
It might not be that the ride's falling apart.
And you and I, who have both worked roller coasters before, know that we've started the day, our days working at the ride, 3-4 hours before the park actually opens.
Yeah.
And then we've been there 2-3 hours at night afterwards.
Yeah.
So it is definitely an intense process
yeah.
to prevent something like this from occurring, but I don't really know what else the industry could do to prevent this.
Yeah. And I think that's all these reasons why, with being preventive maintenance and proper ride training and having a lot of standards and set rules for the guests, really help make theme parks and roller coasters extremely safe.
Exactly. So Frank, rides have internal computer systems in them
yep.
to prevent anything from possibly, any potential incident from possibly occurring.
Mm-hmm.
Some of these include block segments, which only allow one train to be on a part of the track at a time, which we'll talk more in a later video.
Yep.
Some of these include safety sensors that detect motion. Some of these include ride restricted gates and all these other different factors that go into making sure that nothing is wrong with a ride.
Yep, exactly.
Now, if any little tiny thing, even if a bird flies through a sensor, the ride will automatically default
yep.
to an automatic emergency stop situation.
Yep.
This is not an issue and not a dangerous situation to be in.
Yeah.
It's just something that a ride does to be extra cautious when mm-hmm. it comes to any potential thing that's not 110% correct.
And that's why a lot of times these downtimes happen, is because these ride roller coaster systems are so complex and they're almost too safe that it can easily trick an alarm and then the ride will go down.
Exactly, exactly. Overall, this was a pretty good discussion on how different accidents can happen on a roller coaster or any other type of attraction.
Yep.
And we talked a little bit about height checks earlier. I think for our next segment, we're going to talk about all of the facets that go into height checks and different rider requirements to an experience and attraction.
Yeah. So let us know what you guys think. What do you think is the biggest cause of an accident on a ride or roller coaster? Let us know.
And be sure to like us on Facebook, subscribe to us on YouTube, and subscribe to us on Apple and Spotify.
Thank you so much for tuning in. Have a great day.
Bye. Bye.
He stopped.